Faunte Peanut, Faunte Peanut, Faunte Peanut last night I found a peanut, found a peanut last night. Where'd you find it, where'd you find it, where'd you find it last night, where'd you find it, where'd you find it last night? In the dustbin last night, in the dustbin last night. Cracked it open last night I cracked it open last night. Found it rotten last night I found it rotten last night. Ate it anyway last night I ate it anyway last night. I felt sick last night I felt sick last night. Called the doctor last night I called the doctor last night. Went to heaven last night I went to heaven last night. Didn't want me last night they didn't want me last night.
So, ich bin arbeitssuchend. Daher lese ich das Arbeitsrechtshandbuch Schaub Arbeitsrechtshandbuch 17. Auflage CH Beck Verlag. Ich bin angekommen in Unionsrecht und Arbeitsrecht, Paragraph 4. Und um den vernünftig verstehen zu können und einzuordnen zu können, habe ich angefangen, ein anderes Buch zu lesen und zu übersetzen, nämlich European Union Law. Und ich bin angekommen in der Einführung. Und die ist geschrieben worden von den beiden Herausgebern, Catherine Benard und Steve Pierce. Das Kapitel heißt Introduction und ich bin angekommen in der Section 2, The Development of EU Law, die Entwicklung des EU-Rechts. Ich lese immer so einen ganzen Absatz vor und dann versuche ich den satzweise zu übersetzen. Ja, mal gucken, wie weit ich komme. So. The EU has also become a major forum for integration as regards issues which at first sight are non-economic. While the EU always had a common policy on trade with third, that is to see non-EU countries, known as the Common Commercial Policy, and many of its internal policies have significant external dimensions. For example, EU environment policy. The EU has also taken steps towards creating a common foreign and security policy, including defense issues. In addition, the EU has increasingly addressed issues within the scope of justice and home affairs, matters traditionally seen as lying at the heart of national sovereignty, in particular criminal law and immigration and asylum matters. In practice, even these issues have important links with economic integration. Since the abolition of border controls between most member states has meant that it is easier for alleged criminals to flee from one member state to another, and harder to apply a purely national policy on asylum and immigration. So, boah, naja, damit werde ich die nächsten paar Minuten auch noch klarkommen. So. Ich habe gerade einmal geschleppt. So, jetzt Satz für Satz. The EU has also become a major forum for integration as regards issues which at first sight are non-economic. Die EU ist auch ein Hauptforum der Integration, der europäischen Integration geworden, mit Blick auf Themen, die auf den ersten Blick nicht ökonomisch sind. The EU has also become a major forum for integration as regards issues which at first sight are non-economic. While the EU always had a common policy on trade with that is to say non-EU countries, known as the Common Commercial Policy, and many of its internal policies have significant external dimension. For example, EU environment policy. The EU has also taken steps towards creating a common foreign and security policy, including defense issues. Okay, das ist ein ziemlich langer Satz. Ich lese den nochmal vor. Das geht wirklich nur auf Englisch, dass man so viel in einen Satz packt. Ich hätte auch auf Deutsch da mehrere Sätze draus machen müssen. Deshalb ist das Ganze auch so anstrengend. Und gucken, wie lange ich heute durchhalte. While the EU always had a common policy on trade with third, that is to say non-EU countries, known as a common commercial policy, and many of its internal policies have a significant external dimension, for example, environment policy, the EU has also taken steps towards creating a common foreign and security policy, including defense issues. So. Während die EU schon immer eine einheitliche Common Policy, einheitliche Politik, einheitliche politische Position, was den Handel mit Drittländern angeht, das heißt Nicht-EU-Ländern, die bekannt ist als die Common Commercial Policy, gemeinsame Außenhandelspolitik oder gemeinsame Handelspolitik, und diese Konstruktion and many of its internal policies, Die meisten, and many heißt an der Stelle die meisten. Viele kann man in Englisch nicht so steigern. Auf Deutsch viele mehr die meisten. And many heißt mehr oder die meisten. In den meisten Fällen heißt es many. Die meisten so. And many of its internal policies have a significant external dimension, for example, EU environmental policy. Die meisten of ihrer internen politischen Positionen haben policies. Ich guck mal policies nach, wie das da übersetzt wird. Vielleicht fällt mir noch ein besseres Wort ein. Politics, political. Policy mit Y. Und einem L. Policy steht gar nicht. Politics. Doch, ich bin zu doof nachzugucken. Hier steht es ja. Policy. Noun. Policies plural. So, a plan of action agreed or chosen by a political party, a business, the present government's policy on education, politischer Plan, Beschluss, ich sag glaube ich demnächst Beschluss dazu. The company has adopted a firm policy on shoplifting, im Grunde heißt es Beschluss, ökonomischer oder politischer Beschluss. The company has adopted a firm policy on shoplifting. We have tried to pursue a policy of neutrality, a foreign domestic policy. They have had a significant change in policy on paternity leave. Beispielsätze sind am besten. They have had a significant change in policy on paternity leave. A policy document, collections, at politics, formal a principle that you believe in that influences how you behave, the way in which you usually behave. She is following her usually policy of ignoring all offers of help. Honesty is the best policy. A written statement of a contract of insurance. Check the terms of the policy before you sign. Word find a note at insurance. Wahrscheinlich kann man da auch mal nachgucken, findet dann weitere. Oder noch ein Beispielsatz, wo Policy drin oder kommt da noch mal irgendwie vor. So. Ja, sehr schön. Also, wir übersetzen es mal erstmal. Schluss. of its internal policies have a significant external dimension, for example environment policy. Die meisten ihrer internen Beschlüsse haben eine signifikante externe Dimension, einen signifikanten externen Einfluss, zum Beispiel die Umweltpolitik. Die Beschlüsse zur Umweltpolitik. The EU has also taken steps towards creating a common foreign and security policy. Die EU hat außerdem Schritte unternommen, um eine einheitliche außenpolitische und sicherheitspolitische Position zu gewinnen, including defense issues, die auch Fragen der militärischen Verteidigung berühren. So, nächster Satz. Ich lese mal den nochmal vor. While the EU always had a common policy on trade with third, that is to say non-EU countries, known as a common commercial policy, and many of its internal policies have a significant external dimension, for example, environment policy. The EU has also taken steps towards creating a common foreign and security policy, including defense issues. In addition, the EU has increasingly addressed issues within the scope of justice and home affairs, matters traditionally seen as lying at the heart of national sovereignty. So, the in particular criminal law and immigration and asylum matters. So, scope, habe ich glaube ich schon mal nachgeguckt. Spätestens da merkt man wieder, dass ich kein Englisch kann, weil ich mir sowas nicht merke. Scout, Scorch, Scooter, Scoot, Scoot, Scooped, Scooped, Hello Key Scoped, Scooped, also Scoop, to Scoop, only before noun, off the neck of a woman in dress, it is Nacken. Cut low and round is neckline. So, the scoop. Scoop steht da nicht, das steht scope. So, scope. Richtig ausgesprochen. Noun. Was ist eigentlich der Unterschied zwischen scoop und scope? Noun, the opportunity or ability to do or achieve something potential. There's still plenty of scope for improvement. Her job offers very little scope for promotion. The extra money will give us the scope to improve our facilities. Möglichkeit. First try to do something that is within your scope, the range of things that a subject or organization or activity it is, etc. deals with, our scope of our investigation. These issues were outside the scope of the article. Scope in nouns, an instrument for looking through or watching something with microscope, telescope. In diesem Fall heißt es wirklich Blickwinkel. Kann aber auch Möglichkeit heißen. So. Scope of Justice, Blickwinkel der Justiz. In addition, the EU has increasingly addressed issues within the scope of justice and home affairs, matters traditionally seen as lying at the heart of national sovereignty, in particular criminal law and immigration and asylum matters. Zusätzlich hat die EU mit steigender Intensität Dinge in dem, sich Dingen zugewandt, die im Blickwinkel der Justiz und Innenpolitik stehen. Matt is traditional seen as a lying at the heart of national sovereignty. Angelegenheiten, die traditionell als im Herzen nationaler Souveränität liegend gesehen werden. In particular criminal law and immigration and asylum matters, im Speziellen sind dies Strafrecht und Immigrations- und Asylangelegenheiten. In practice, even these issues have important links with economic integration. Since the abolition of border control between most member states, that it is easier for alleged criminals to flee. So, ich fange nochmal an. Den Satz habe ich eben schon nicht verstanden. In practice, even these issues have important links with economic integration, since the abolition of border control between most states has meant that it is easier to urge criminals to flee from one member state to another and harder to apply to a purely national policy on asylum and immigration. So. In practice, even these issues have important links with economic integration, since the abolition of border controls between most member states had meant that it is easier for alleged criminals to flee from one member state to another and harder to apply a purely national policy on asylum and immigration. So, jetzt habe ich es, glaube ich. So, das hier kann ich wegmachen. Damit ist der Absatz auch schon zu Ende. Ich höre nach dem Absatz auf und lese nur noch englischen Text vor. Das ist weniger anstrengend. In practice, even these issues have important links with economic integration. So. In practice, in der Realität, in dem, was tatsächlich angewandt und gemacht wird, haben diese Issues, diese Angelegenheiten important links with economic integration, wichtige Verknüpfungen mit der ökonomischen Integration. Also in der gelebten Praxis haben selbst diese Angelegenheiten wichtige Verknüpfungen mit der ökonomischen Integration. Since the abolition of border controls between most member states had meant that it is easier for alleged criminals to flee from one member state to another. Seitdem die Abschaffung der Grenzkontrollen zwischen den meisten Mitgliedstaaten dazu geführt haben, dass es einfacher ist für verfolgte Kriminelle von einem Land, von einem Mitgliedsland ins andere zu fliehen. And harder to apply a purely national policy on asylum and immigration. Und das hat auch dazu geführt, dass es schwieriger geworden ist, eine ausschließlich nationale Position oder einen nationalen Beschluss zu Asyl und Immigration anzuwenden, zu leben. So, damit ist der Absatz zu Ende. Ich lese jetzt einfach für die letzten 30 Minuten im Buch weiter. Ich muss das mehrmals lesen, weil ich finde den Text relativ erst wortreich und die Sätze sind lang und damit ist es für jemanden, der nicht täglich sein Brot damit verdient, so wie ich das bin, schwierig sowas zu übersetzen. Along with this widening of EU of the material scope of EU law, the EU territorial scope has widened greatly too, with its membership expanding from 6 to 28 member states. The ever-growing impact of EU law has also been accelerated by the very nature of EU law, because for many member states EU law has a much greater force within national legal systems than most other international treaties. Indeed, there's an important debate as to whether EU law can still be regarded as a forum of international law at all, or whether it has become sui generis, it's like chop suey, but with mushrooms. Schlechte englische Witze. We are living in a wonderful world of gravity. And I promise not to do my silly walks. Meaning in a class by itself. Did I mention that I'm unemployed and searching for jobs even in Great Britain? So, and I promise if I get an offer from Great Britain, I'm seeing London Bridge is falling down. So. Den Verbrechern, Herr der Sklaven, wache auf! So. Sui generis is like sui generis is like chop suey, but with mushrooms. Over the years, the EU law has not just widened its material and territorial scope, but it has also developed a complex institutional framework for the adoption and enforcement of its legal law, establishing both political and judicial system to the end. To my mind, I've read this text before. Sorry. establishing both a political and judicial system to that end. So English, a foreign language with lots of variations to learn in order to get the grammar at the right point. Like any complex legal system, the EU has developed basic principles that govern the application of that system, as well as the rules which govern its administration. One of these key principles is the requirement to protect human rights, which has become increasingly important as, for example, EU law concerns itself with more issues, for example, criminal law and asylum, that impact upon civil liberties, and that as EU austerity policies intended to address the economic and financial crisis linked to EMU. Have an ever greater impact upon social rights. Social rights. Oh, wrong hand. Social rights. So, Last night I found a peanut last night. Ate your peanuts last night. Last night I ate your peanuts. Ate your peanuts last night. You're suffering hunger right now. You're suffering hunger right now. So, more broadly, the constitutional and administrative law of the EU did I mention that if I get a job in Great Britain, I'll sing in camera, London Bridge is falling down. So, more broadly, the constitutional and administrative law of the EU has a whole raise questions about the nature of national sovereignty in the EU legal orders and the EU's fidelity to basic constitutional principles such as the separation of powers. Hello, keys. This raises even more fundamental questions. Does the EU have a constitution following the demise of the constitutional treaty, and if so, what sort? What does the EU's special brand of constitutionalism accommodate uniformity and diversity, as well as the role of the center and that of national and subnational actors? This has led to an increasingly sophisticated debate about the role of multi-level governance, the idea that there are various interacting authority structures at work within the EU. But it also raises questions as to how the EU related to other major international bodies outside of its own sphere of influence. The United Nations is a prime example. As featured in the terrorist asset freezing cases, how open can and should the EU be to these external bodies? Okay, damit ist Chapter 1 Introduction beendet. Section 2 in Chapter 1 beendet. Section 3 is themes, and there are two themes: input legitimacy and output legitimacy. Ich lese einfach mal weiter. Ich habe noch 25 Minuten auf der Uhr. Themes. Chapter 1, Section 3, Themes. The chapter of this book are linked by overreaching themes, which can be introduced in the form of two questions. What should you be doing? And how should you go about doing it? The question of what the you should do is linked to the concept of output legitimacy. Okay, das kommt als zweites. Typisch britisch, das zuerst zu nehmen. Gute Juristen schreiben ihre Briefe auch so. In Deutschland gibt es keine. Ich muss am Donnerstag zum Insolvenzverwalter. Der Anwalt hat in der Güteverhandlung gewonnen. In Solingen gibt es so einen Arschloch, der sieht aus wie ein großer Teddybär, stellt einem zur Vorbereitung nicht mal mehr einen Tisch und einen Stuhl zur Verfügung. Und er kann Prozesse schon im Gütetermin beenden. Der kann auch Anträge im Güteverfahren entgegennehmen und fragt sogar aktiv danach. Ich habe noch nie so eine Hohlfritte auf einem Richterstuhl gesehen. Das kann man sich gar nicht mehr vorstellen. Hallo, Herr Lehmberg vom Amtsgericht Solingen. Der soll auch so ein Verfahren gegen die Psycho-Klitsche hier auf der Eichenstraße leiten. Ich habe gegen die geklagt. Er weigert sich, das Verfahren zu eröffnen. Er braucht kommentierte Beweismittel. Der nennt die sogar Beweise. Der ist so dermaßen daneben, der Typ. Das kann man sich gar nicht mehr vorstellen. Ich lebe hier wirklich in einer Apfel-, Birnen- und Bananenrepublik, wo die nichts anderes zu tun haben, als über die Form von Früchten zu debattieren und kein Mensch richtig lesen und schreiben kann. Geschweige denn, dass sie in der Lage sind, ihre eigenen Prozessordnungen, das ist die Strafprozessordnung, Zivilprozessordnung zu lesen und ein Verfahren nach denen durchzuführen. Das ist dermaßen das Allerletzte, was sich in Deutschland abspielt. Das kann man sich gar nicht vorstellen. Deshalb würde ich mich freuen, wenn ich dieses Land endlich verlassen darf. Musste mal gesagt werden. Ich fange mal an mit Themes, Chapter 1, Section 3, Introduction, Section Themes. The chapters of these books are linked by overreaching themes, which can be introduced in the forms of two questions. What should the EU be doing and how should the EU go about doing it? The question of what the EU should do is linked to the concept of output legitimacy, that is, the EU proving its values to the public by showing that it is effective in contributing to the achievement of objectives which have wide public support. For example, economic growth and job creation. The question of how the EU should accomplish these tasks is linked to the concept of input legitimacy. That is, how fair and democratic is the process by which the EU takes decisions. These two types of legitimacy are linked because if the EU tries to do more things, more questions are likely to be raised about its democratic credentials. Indeed, the two forms of legitimacy might come into direct conflict, where, for instance, an attempt to make the EU more effective by removing member states' vetoes over a policy area. So, das muss ich mir nochmal durchlesen. Also. hole mir gerade noch einen Kaffee. Ich habe noch knapp 20 Minuten auf der Uhr, da brauche ich noch einen Kaffee, damit ich hier durchhalte. Ich lese nochmal weiter. The question of how you should accomplish these tasks is linked to the concept of input legitimacy. That is, how fair and democratic is this process by which the EU takes decisions. Okay, also es wird in diesem Buch zuerst darüber geredet, wie was gemacht wird, und dann wird darüber geredet, was gemacht wird, denn es geht weiter mit Input Legitimacy und danach kommt Output Legitimacy. These two types of legitimacy are linked because if the EU tries to do more things, more questions are likely to be raised about its democratic credentials. Indeed, the two forms of legitimacy might come into direct conflict where, for instance, an attempt to make the EU more effective by removing member states' votes over a policy area, which will make it easier for the EU to take decisions, should be seen as a reduction in democratic legitimacy from the point of view of a national parliament, which will no longer even full sovereignty over decision, which will no longer have full sovereignty over decisions in that policy area. Sehr schön. So. Lest nochmal den Kasus Knaxus vor. These two types of legitimacy are linked because if the EU tries to do more things, more questions are likely to be raised about its democratic credentials. Über die democratic credentials wird in Input Legitimacy gesprochen. Das ist wieder so, naja. Indeed, these two